Y'all ready for this?
Y'all ready for this?
Well, I wasn't ready for you doing that, but today we're going to look at the MK Logic Plus Rapid Fix.
You'll be telling me next that socket has no screws.
It has no screws, yeah, you're right. And yeah, a couple of years ago we teased out an image, didn't we?
Yeah, we did.
We suggested that screwless sockets were on the way, and we made this. I mean, it's, yeah, no expense spared.
Okay, patent pending, I see there. So you've glued some Wagos onto the back of a socket outlet.
Yeah, that was it. And then people got all excited about it. People tried to even buy some from us, but that wasn't possible. And then obviously some people came in and said, ooh, do the standards allow for this newfangled screwless technology?
All right, okay. Well, let's see. Does it? Does the standards allow for it now then?
Well, let's just have a quick recap on BS1363-2 amended 2018. I'm sure everyone reads it on a regular basis.
Never put it down.
Yeah, and in there, section 11.1, it mentions screwless terminals and socket outlets. So absolutely is allowed. So it was a case of who's going to be first.
And who were first then?
MK by Honeywell.
Yeah.
And here it is.
And it was quite ironic because I think the socket outlet you glued your Wagos to was also an MK socket. So
it
did
was.
You know something nobody else knew 2 years ago?
Who knows, Gary? Never reveal your sources. Yeah, so let's have a look. I mean, it is, you're right. Yeah, it's amazingly similar.
I'm going to tease it in. There it is. So we've got three levers for each of our conductors there, pretty similar to what you did there. Is there any rules about what those levers need to be able to take then, Gordon?
Yeah, so there's a lot. So I mean, let's start with a conductor sizer. So to be a 13 amp socket,
right.
So we've got an old, you know, very commodity one here, all sockets need to be able to take three 2.5 millimeter conductors,
right.
Or 1.5. You're probably thinking back to your day doing the old mineral
insulated. Yeah.
Or perhaps more common now, two 4 millimeter conductors. So you're thinking of those large radial circuits for a kitchen.
So before we get to that, shall we review what we used to like about the MK Logic Plus socket outlet in their range?
Yeah, so that's it. So yeah, so I'll just turn that one on.
Keep it secret for a little bit longer.
So here's the existing Logic Plus. The first thing we always used to like is the fact that all the terminals are in line on the back.
Yeah.
And so that obviously helps with your cutting lengths. I'm assuming most people, in most cases, are coming from the top or from the bottom. So equal length cutting lengths, backed out screws, but that doesn't matter anymore. That's gone. We don't need that. But turn it over, there's the unique three-pin safety shutter. So if I do this with a screwdriver, don't try this at home, but I can't get the shutter down on the socket.
Can you show me one that does?
Yeah, so here's a very commodity-based product. Yeah, you can easily just put anything in there,
sure,
and get access to the shutter. Now, what a lot of people do, and I don't, again, what used to happen, Gary, back in your day when appliances didn't have plugs on, you could just put the wires in and people used to do things like that. Don't do that at home.
Okay, they used to do things like that, did they?
Yeah, so you can't do that with that three-pin shutter.
Okay, so lots of things in there we liked. We liked obviously terminals in line and the shutters.
Yeah.
We're moving forward. We've got rid of the screws.
We've got them, yeah. And I mean, you know, if you look at the market now, this socket has been out for a long time, nearly 20 years, I think. And, you know, you look in the market, most sockets now, you know, it's a bit like mobile phones. They all look very similar at the front.
A classic design is a classic design, though, isn't it?
Oh, a classic, yeah.
Yeah, it is a classic.
So when it comes to reinventing that, everything else remains the same in terms of those key safety features. And we turn it over, we've still got inline terminals on the back that we like on that socket.
Just coming in a bit slowly for everyone. So here we go again. Yeah.
Yeah. So how do you operate it? Very simple. It's a case of just lift the lever and you'll see the cage clamp open at the back.
Yeah.
You see that again? Just watch. There we go. Yeah. So we can just do that. And there's nice color coded. If you can't read the letters, you hopefully you've got a chance with the colours.
That was for me, was it? No glasses on gas. So when we think about what can go into those holes, is there any rules set about that?
Yeah, so again, if we flick back to the standard itself, and here's what's in the standard for screwless socket outlets. So the terminals must be able to take rigid solid,
okay,
as
yeah.
we would know, a class one conductor,
yeah.
or stranded, a class two conductor. Check out our video on that if you don't understand the different classes of conductor. Or a flexible conductor, class five, or both rigid, solid, or stranded, and flexible copper conductors.
What, at the same time?
Yeah, at the same time, that's what that's reading.
So when we open those up, we could effectively have a class one, class two, and class five conductor in, say, the neutral CPC or line. You got an example?
Yeah, well, let's have a look at this. Yeah, so the worst case, and I don't know when anyone would actually do this, but so here's a 2.5 millimeter.
That's class five?
Yeah.
And what are you going for next?
So here's our regular 2.5 twin and a half.
So solid class one.
Yeah. And where's we got some? So I see a conduit single.
Class two conductor now, so that's solid stranded.
Yeah. And that just goes in and they're in there and they're not coming out. But if I did want to get them out, I just lift the levers and remove them.
It's too simple.
See where that's gripped. You can see the sort of thing we're used to seeing with high quality screwless connectors. You can see where it's bit into the cable, but nowhere near as much as you would do with a screw.
Yeah, and that over tightening is a problem, isn't it? You're screwing everyone's arms different. Some actually go through, weaken the copper. Some of them don't hold it hard enough, but the lever will have exactly the same torque every time that lever is shut onto those conductors.
Yeah, so that's, yeah, so I mean, you know, you wouldn't be able to do that with a, well, you'd struggle to do that with a conventional screwed socket to put three different conductor types in the terminal.
They're all going to move differently, aren't they? So the solid one, you've got the opening up of the stranded ones as well.
Rumendo standard's got to take three 2.5s or two 4 millimeters.
You got some 4 millimeters there?
Some 4 millimeter.
Let's bring the camera and have a look.
So again, wiring dead easy. So obviously the CPC is not 4 millimeters, is it?
No, it's not. It's 1.5.
Put them in. Fits nicely. See, it's exactly sized for that. And I'll just bring our
second one in.
The other one in. So you could actually do three on this.
Yeah, so the standards say it's got to be able to take two 4 millimeter squared cables. And actually, by this design, we could have three.
Yeah.
So if you're wiring an A2 radial socket circuit and wanting to branch off from it, you could branch off again in 4 mm if you wanted to.
Yeah, which then gets us thinking about the back box, doesn't it? Because our first thoughts when we saw this is it's
a fraction.
Yeah,
it but is slightly deeper,
let's
isn't it?
Check them out there again. If I look back and compare it with the existing Logic Plus, you can see most components on the back are the same. You can see where the three pins come in from the plug. The earth bar's been shifted about a bit to link the two sides together. But all in all, it remains the same. However, when you look at the side, there is a slight height difference where the levers are.
Yeah.
And we thought, ooh.
25mm box.
25mm box. So let's just have a little look in the back. We've got one here. Now you can see. You see the earth terminal in the middle there looks quite close to the back of the box.
Well, the only way to actually prove it is to fit one, isn't it?
Yeah.
So it's to take those probably two conventional 2.5 millimeter square cables, maybe as a ring final circuit on a 25 mil box, and see if you can dress them back into it. Shall we look at that next?
Let's have a look.
The packet the RapidFIXX socket comes in has safety and installation instructions, and it's worth reading those first. We're going to need to strip our conductors back to 10 mil, which is indicated here on the back of the socket outlet. Take my Preki stripper that I've set to 10 mil in order to strip these back. Trying to make it nice and easy for myself. So that's 10 mil. I will confirm it as well. So strip them back. Once I've got my conductors to the required length, I'm just going to check them. So confirm they are 10 mil, and they are. And now it's a simple case of lifting the levers. You can see the holes open up to allow the conductors to enter. Do one more, so have a look in there. You don't need to lift all three if you're only inserting one or two conductors, but you do have to lift the lever in order to insert the conductors into the back of the socket. Nice simple task now. This is really quick. So just position your conductors, pop them in. I'm gonna do my neutrals first. I'm gonna do both neutrals. I know normally with a socket outlet, you do both the conductors at the same time. You could do them individually this time. I could have done the line next or the CPC, but I'm gonna do the traditional way of putting both conductors in first. So that's my neutrals connected. CPCs, just a word of warning, as always, to hold on tightly to the conductor and we don't just move the sleeve in forward. In that case, you might find that we don't get it inside the clamp. So always do a tug test on all conductors. So yep, tug test, they're in, nice and firmly. And it's onto my line conductors. Simply pop them in and that'll be connected. And it goes back to that firm connection from the lever. I'm not worried about how tight I've got them with a screwdriver. So they're in. Push them back to the wall next. Dress them as normal. So you've just got to move them around according to where you think they're going to sit best, and then we can just push it back to the wall and then just put our screws in. And that was in a 25 mil deep box, and I had no issues at all in order to get that done. Second socket outlet, now we'll see the cables now come in from the bottom. The first one came in from the top, exactly the same process. I'm just going to run through it quickly once more. 10 mil for my conductors, lift up my levers. I've got three CPCs this time. I've got the fly lead to the back of the box as well. So I've lifted up only the levers I required this time. And we're going to start off again with the neutrals, push them firmly into place and close down the lever. Little tug test once again, and a tug test, and that's it. It's just a simple process. You know, we said in the opening, we couldn't believe that it hadn't been done before, but it has been done now. So take advantage of the fact that you can have screwless socket outlets in the installation and the reliability that they offer. One more CPC. Once all my conductors are in, I'll obviously confirm again that it goes into the back of the 25 mil box, this time with the cables coming in from below. Just my line conductors now to insert. Swinging it around as you would normally. Still want it to be neat. Push it into place and click it down. One more to go, and then I'll push them back. Again, dress the cables before doing so as you normally would, making sure you stay away from the screwed areas, and just wiggle it back onto the wall. Give you a different shot now. You can see from above as I screw this one in now. So no issues at all in order to get it back onto the wall. Just finish it off. I think we clearly see there, that was a lot easier than the standard screwed socket outlet, and there was no issues with the 25 mil back box either.
So how did you find that, Gary?
Ever so easy. Dress those cables, push it back into the box, no issues at all with the depth for me.
Okay, and that and you did the trial, obviously coming top and bottom.
I did, yeah.
Where most people coming in, I don't think there'd be any problems coming to the sides either. But faster, would you say?
A lot faster, okay. And it's the reliability of the electrical connection. I think I found out over the last couple of weeks when we've been trialing these, is that I'm quite aggressive with the way I screw into a socket outlet because of the guns.
Oh, right, I thought it was your personality again.
And what I'm finding is that I'm actually making a large dent into that copper. And of course, you know, you take it off for testing, you take it off for decorating, you take it off, and there's a chance of snapping it. Whereas I felt those levers, obviously, were loads quicker. But obviously, I haven't got the problem with the amount of torque being put on because the lever does it for
you. Yeah, exactly. How many times have you removed a socket and there's a broken in there because someone aggressive's been in before, causing trouble in the installation.
Yeah, I don't think I can have a product recall for all of the ones I've ever fitted over my lifetime. But also ring final circuit testing. How many times we've been to a consumer unit and an open-ended ring and have found it's an actual broken conductor? I'd like to think personally that these levers will pretty much remove that because of the torque on obviously the lever when it goes down.
Yeah, so I mean, it's branded a rapid fix. So I mean, one of the major selling points is quicker to install. Now, obviously don't take Gary's word for it. He's not the fastest around here. So we decided to hand it over to some tame electricians to see how quickly they could fit this compared to the existing MK screwed socket. So check out that video when it comes out. That's a treat to watch.
It is. And it's just proving the fact, isn't it? Well, we believe the rapid fix socket from MK Honeywell will be faster to install than the standard 13 amp socket outlet. But as always, we're interested in your feedback and your comments. Have you fitted this socket outlet and believe it is quicker? Are you already a massive fan of a Wago connector and you, like us, couldn't believe how long it's taken for them to be introduced the technology behind them onto the back of a socket outlet? And do you think switches will be next and fuse connection units and all the rest of it?
Watch this space, Gary. We'll have to see what we can create first.
Yeah, we'll get the patent pending on the next one. But always, we're interested in your comments. Is it the greatest innovation since the incandescent lamp? Leave those comments below and we'll try and get back to as many as we can.